NDC has been a topic of speculation and opportunity in the travel industry for many years. For online travel agencies or OTAs, it represents an opportunity to deliver more personalized omni-channel offers and value-driving content. But many OTA representatives still wonder, what will NDC content look like? What difference will it make to my daily workflow? Here are the biggest changes NDC will bring to OTAs. For starters, NDC content will only be available to agencies who consume NDC APIs, so make sure your agency plans to integrate our Sabre NDC-enabled APIs. Once you have access to NDC content, one of the biggest changes NDC will bring to travelers is a visible offer lifespan, known as time to live. This tells travelers how much time they have to book an offer. With traditional content, travelers aren't made aware of an offer's lifespan, or there haven't been time limits, so this is an important change. Next, the OTA will need to identify the content source, as this will affect how the offer is processed. Traditional content, NDC content, and low-cost carrier content follow different booking processes, so OTAs will need to ensure they are handled appropriately. In the fulfillment and payment part of the booking process, OTAs must recognize the ticketing time limit, which identifies the time frame in which payment must be completed. With NDC, the ticketing time limit may be the same or it could be different, so it's important to verify. On the payment side, the traveler will notice no changes, though some payment options may be different with NDC. Finally, for the post-booking automation process, making changes on NDC orders will require a different set of APIs, either to add or edit fields or make changes in the itinerary. Want to know more about other workflow changes and what NDC means to OTAs? Visit Sabre's NDC site. Ready to get started? Contact your Sabre account manager.